filled today, so I called my neighbors at this church and they said, go ahead and use it. So I give thanks for that congregation because we're that kind of neighbors for each other. And this is a worship service. It's a memorial service. It's a remembrance of Randy. The celebration. In my tradition, we would call it a witness to the resurrection. Remembering and trusting that he is with God and life is whole and better than we know. We come to the service to remember a person we knew and loved and trust our future to something greater than ourselves. And you all, you are friends and family and people from work and people from all over to remember them. And there will be times for you to tell stories today and to hear things about Randy and to tell stories downstairs. And in some ways, I'm a little bit of an interloper. I have never met Randy. But I know Lee, and that's why I'm here. And we, today, begin this worship with a word of prayer. Let us pray. God of creation, God of sun, God who made San Francisco, God who made human beings who fall in love, God who made creatures, God who made us, we give you thanks for the life of Randy. We give you thanks for his life in our life. We ask you to be with us as we remember, as we grieve, as we celebrate, as tears flow. Be with us today and all the days of our lives. Amen. So again, it's a bit odd to have me here. And maybe if you knew Randy, it's a little odd to have a pastor, I don't know. And one who's been working to say his name right, Algar. I got it right? See, I shouldn't even try. I got myself so worked up. For a $2 lunch, it's the best in town. You see, Lee comes to my senior center at my church with your adults from ARC. And we sit at a table and we eat lunch and we just kind of became friends. One, because there was often a seat next to him, I don't know why, but he loves. And also because we're both Southerners. I spent 20 years in the South and came back. I was born here but came back to the Promised Land so we could talk things Southern. And then he would talk about family histories. And then he trusted me enough to tell me about this man he had married and let me see the website. Have you all, some of you were at the wedding? Have you seen the website? I watched it, but I feel like I was kind of there. You did a fine service, let me say. You did. And he also, Lee, let me know when you weren't doing well and some of your struggles with health. Thought we had gotten through that. And then Randy got his diagnosis of cancer. So you kind of told me things. I don't think officially I'm his pastor, but I'm as close as you get. I'm up here. What are you going to do at this point? I'm wearing a robe. So that's why I'm doing this service, because I really care about this man. And I understood that Randy needed a place for you all to remember him and to honor him. Because this is an exceptional, your husband was an exceptional man. And so we've gathered people together. Again, family and friends and colleagues all here to tell stories. Now what I know about Randy, life has had some unexpected things. It's kind of like you are a Southern man. As we were saying downstairs, you can dress him up, but he is still Southern. And Randy, he was a typical man from New Jersey, from New York. I mean, he knew what he thought. Isn't that true? Yeah. So you take the Southern boy. When you met, you were both. I mean, we were all young, 20-some years ago. And you met each other in a place that was unlikely. You were at the Shanti when you were doing kind of caregiving. You all know this. want to tell them what you know, that you were caring for people with AIDS and HIV back in the 80s when that disease was just devastating San Francisco. My church can't talk about it. It was just ripping apart this community and taking those that we loved and those that made the city so strong. But there were those that cared deeply and well, and you met me on a volunteer training. And there you were supposed to be caring, and you kind of fell off. I mean, you were smitten right away. I'm being nice to use the words. Oh, yes, you were. And I you fell in love quickly and fell hard for each other. I mean, I'm going to be polite because I'm wearing the robe, but you held hands, and that you weren't stopping after that. There was a joy in that. And it wasn't just a joy of being able to have this electric kind of bond with a man. It was something that went deeper and went strong. And I think that's kind of what held you together. I mean, they planned to grow old together. That was the plan. You said rocking chairs or whatever the San Francisco equivalent is, how you were going to live your lives. 33 years you've been together. Do I have that number right? 22. Well, that's long enough. Lord have mercy. 22 years. That in San Francisco, that in any life is a gift. And an amazing thing. But the hard thing is when you love someone that long, it means with a death like this, your heart is just ripped open. And so you give thanks for that love, but it also means the hurt is so great. But he's still with you. And that's the truth. That's what these people will remind you of that gift of having this man who could speak and fill up a room from what I'm told, and yet valued your kind of quietness. It was a good relationship. And then, I don't know how, but I have to mention your dog, Darwin. I mean, this is your child. It's true. Kind of came and was that place you did extra love, got you into the neighborhood, probably helped you meet more neighbors than you knew. And that was another place that kind of bonded you together. And so we have husband, and then we have this sister, Linda. Older sister. He was the younger brother. Any of you have a younger brother, you know how that is. You have to work with them. And you know, you get caught with everything because your younger one watches how to act well. Well, that was Randy. He learned by watching. But you kind of took care of him. And the joy of it, even though, you know, he was kind of, Randy's kind of the smart one. No surprise there. I mean, he went to Harvard. And you were the one that just kind of had a good time. But you know, he was your brother and really cared about him. And here's the amazing thing, they grew up and they got to be best friends. Doesn't happen with every sibling. And he would call you just to kind of bug you and tell you what was going on, and Lord, they would talk about the dog. Darwin, that was like, they would talk about the dog. That was what they did. And you know how good this man is. You would say that, Lee was one of the better things that happened to Randy. It was good for him. And so they got to celebrate that piece too. And you know, in many families, that doesn't always happen. So we give thanks for family that gets to celebrate that. And then a lot of you knew him as friend and colleague. Now, I didn't know Randy was a big thing, but he was. I mean, he met President Obama. And he did that not because he was this polite, quiet kind of man. He was there because he was an activist with a loud voice. When he got HIV and later AIDS, he did not become quiet about that. He became an activist. I think you said he kind of lived his life out loud. Well, he'd been doing that since you knew him, since he was a boy. But he started using that. His actions and his words said, this HIV AIDS, we are not going to be quiet about it. It's not going to go away, and we are going to keep working hard for that. So he took on this activist voice. And people listened to him. I think sometimes because he spoke really well, and sometimes because he would not be quiet. And I think we need that in the world. And then when he got the diagnosis of anal cancer, he wouldn't be quiet. People are quiet about cancer, and he would not. talked about this disease that goes to many people, and we're just, oh, we're too embarrassed. Well, he would not be embarrassed. And he started the blog and said, we're going to talk on this because we are together, and that's kind of how he is. And the sadness is that this disease took him. This was not the way it was supposed to be. And there is a loss and grief that is large for you, Lee, and I think in this community that are his friends. So we come here today to remember him. Not a perfect man. I think you can tell some stories downstairs. But a man that lived his life in an authentic way. A man who cared about his community, the ones he knew and the ones he did not. A man that laughed a lot. A man that loved well. And so today, I feel it's my loss because I didn't actually know him, but I feel like I did. So today, we will tell stories and remember and thank God for his life.